idea of starting a business first comes to you, at first you feel like you're about to change the world with this groundbreaking brainwave. But we're here to tell you, you might want to make sure the groundwork is all done first. A report by Business Insider analyzing over 20 million small businesses around the world revealed that 75% of small business owners are confident that their business will survive beyond infancy. What about the numbers close to home? In 2016, Kenya's National Bureau of Statistics put out a report that showed that almost 400,000 businesses did not make it past their first 2 years. And 2.2 million businesses actually closed down within a period of 5 years. So what are the reasons small businesses fail? Take a look at these. Most of the businesses experience cash flow issues, while a smaller portion, about 40%, don't have the right market. And some are yet to learn how to fight competition and create the right team. Bottom line, for your business to catch on, maybe escape the danger of going under in infancy, survive your first 2 years. Our reporter Hudefa Adan spoke to the CEO of Africa Guarantee Fund. He asked him some of the challenges SMEs are facing in Africa.
Today in Africa, the SME, they are facing a lot of challenges. A survey was conducted by the World Bank, and so the result that they got from this survey is that 50% of the SME, they close after 1 year of operation, which is too bad. We have four main reasons. The first reason is the poor quality of infrastructure in Africa. We are talking mainly about the energy infrastructure, because today when you see the shortage of power, that slows down the growth of the SME in Africa. We also have the transport infrastructure. Today, when you see the quality of road in Africa, it's a big challenge for the SME to have access to the market. And lastly, we have the telecommunication infrastructure. Today, Africa is lagging behind when it comes to the digital economy. So the second reason, what I would say, is the shortage of skills. We are talking mainly, at the moment, we are lacking skill in marketing, in accounting, in customer relationship. The third reason why SME, they are facing also a big challenge in Africa is the legal environment. This is mainly a problem on taxation, on business permit. You know, in some countries, it takes too long to have access to a business permit, the land title. Yeah. And then the last one is access to finance. This is what at AGF we are mainly trying to cover.
Then how are you trying to help in access to finance for the SME sector?
Okay, so today in Africa, the SME financing gap is estimated to be at $150 billion. And what are the reasons of this gap? So the first gap is the information gap, because you know the bank, they are lacking information on SME to do a proper risk assessment. We have the collateral gap. You know, the collateral kind of requirement by the bank is quite tough, and the SME are not able to provide this type of collateral that is needed by the bank. Another challenge is the resource gap. We tend to say that the bank in Africa, they are very liquid, but when you see the type of liquidity that they have, it's more of a short-term liquidity, when the SME, they need long-term liquidity to grow. And then, so what we are trying to do is to tackle all these different gaps so that we can give our guarantee product to the bank so that they can lend more to the SME. So by sharing the risk that they are taking on the SME business.
That was Jules Gankam, the deputy CEO of AGF. Moving on.